Welcome back, Trojan fans, and welcome to another episode of the West Brunswick Coaches Show. Have a brand new guest on the show tonight, Coach Amanda Nobles. Coach, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Good to finally have you on here.
Good to be here.
I feel like we're interviewing, you know, generations of the Nobles family.
Yes, we seem to be.
Tell us about that. How did you get into coaching?
Well, I played at West. I graduated from there in 03, and I went on and played college ball and all of that.
And tell us where you played college at.
Charleston Southern University.
Outstanding. Right down the road.
I loved it. I stayed at close to home so that my parents could come see me play.
And I'm sure they did.
They did quite often. That was my goal, was for them to be able to come. After that, I actually went over to Greece and played ball and tried out for the pro league.
Look at this. We got a world traveler here, folks.
I loved it, but I had to come back very quickly because of some issues with things that were happening in that area at the time.
I remember some of that.
Yeah,
that
was there.
That was a difficult part of the world.
It was quite rough. There were lots of riots and all kinds of things that I could actually walk through and nobody would touch me. It was really kind of scary, but neat at the same time.
So but you missed Brunswick County too, right?
I did. I got very homesick while I was there. Decided to come home. Well, they made me come home. And I tried out for the pro league and decided after I made it, they asked me to come back the year later. And I just decided to come home and help Dad coach and fell in love with it.
Well, that's quite the trip.
It's been kind of a crazy one.
You got to see the world and let softball pay for it.
Yes, sir.
Fantastic. Well, it's good to have you home.
Thank you.
Good to have you working with our youth in the community at the school here. And we got great things going on over there.
We do.
A lot of these girls play year-round now.
They do, and it has honestly helped our program tremendously.
With the specialization that I talked to your father a little bit about in especially pitching in mm-hmm. softball, how many pitches are some of these girls throwing in it? Is there a limit? Do you tap it?
No. It's a natural motion, and there's absolutely nothing that can hurt the shoulder, okay. Unlike baseball.
Yep.
So there's really no cap on number of pitches. It's just more how long they can last.
Gotcha.
So
there is a lot of fatigue involved.
There's a lot of fatigue. We do send our pitchers on runs daily to try to build that up.
Yep.
They can pitch 3, 4, 5 games in a day if need be. And it's no
wow.
harm to the shoulder.
No Tommy John surgery.
No, not at all.
That's different than what I'm used to.
It is very different.
And we talked about velocity, too, with your father. Who's our hardest throwing pitcher right now?
Morgan Beeler. She is my sophomore pitcher. She's outstanding this year. She's had one no-hitter against, I believe it was Hoggard, which was her very first career no-hitter.
We love beating Wilmington schools.
Yes, we do.
We love beating every school.
We love it. I think our biggest one was the other night, though. Friday night, we beat Topsail.
Number one ranked Topsail.
Number one ranked Topsail.
If I'm not mistaken.
So. It was awesome.
West Brunswick got them when they were number one, but they may not be number one for long.
That's right. We're
going to
take that. Yeah. We're going to take that.
Outstanding. So tell us about so far we've played, is it 5 conference games?
We have. We are 4-1.
Okay. I like that. 80% is good.
We kind of let it slide a little bit against Laney, but we'll get them next time.
Gotcha.
We had kind of a rough night. We walked a couple batters where we shouldn't have, and it happens.
Out of conference hadn't been as prosperous maybe as the in-conference schedule.
Yeah, we've lost 2 non-conference games. We're 7-3 overall.
Which is fantastic,
which is still great.
Yeah.
coming off of the Topsail win Friday night, we went to Pittsboro, North Carolina, and we played Orange County, and we played Northwood High School. And we didn't have such a great day on that one.
What happened? Were they sleepwalking? Was it the idea of a long road trip? Was it just too much fun?
I honestly think it was the win from Topsail.
Gotcha.
We were so high, and that's so emotionally draining.
Had to knock them back just a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think they've realized that you got to go no matter what. You got to go no matter what. You got to hold that level.
They got the same number of players on the field that we do, right?
Exactly.
So.
So,
any given weekend.
Any given time, any given night.
How does that affect you when you've already played some conference games? And the conference schedule is pretty systematic. Mm-hmm. But when you do something like that and you make a weekend trip, how do you keep them engaged?
Just through practice. I mean, we just came back today, and I mean, we had some conversations about some little issues that we're trying to just keep in our grasp, and we just got right back at it, got in the cage, and went back to working on our hitting, which was the part that was lacking a little bit. And I mean, honestly, with our team, they're pretty much self-motivated. They do a great job of it.
Well, considering you have a young team,
it's kind of shocking.
Yeah,
but it's really kind of neat because they are a lot of times self-motivated.
Who's the leader on that team? You know, it's great when the players can almost run practice.
Mm-hmm.
Who, if you had to run a practice with just one of your players, who are you going to send out there?
That's really kind of hard because we have a lot of, at different times, we have different leaders.
Okay. Explain.
In practices, we oftentimes divide up and we go infield and outfield.
Right.
And there's been a couple times where I've had a couple surgeries with my mouth and stuff where I've been out, and my outfielders, because that's what I run a lot of, my juniors have stepped up and have kind of taken over, and they know my routines, and they have pretty much run the outfield practice while Dad runs the infield. But game situations, it really kind of depends on the night. A lot of times our senior shortstop, Mackenzie Benton, will step up and kind of keep the team going. And then other nights we have our freshman who steps up and says, hey, guys, we got to get going.
And when you're working with the outfield, your dad's working with the infield, are the pitchers, like, playing hot foot?
That is when our pitchers are actually running.
Okay.
Our pitchers come in, our pitchers and catchers come in early every day at 2:45, and we go through a practice with them.
Gotcha.
I'm with them at that time.
It's tough being a pitcher because you got to have an edge to do that, because you're standing.
You do.
It's, you know, you're standing a lot closer.
Well,
to the
when
plate.
You're standing on the mound, you're 45 feet away, and most of our pitchers get 8 to 10 feet off the mound on their drive.
So
they're at about 37, 35, somewhere in there.
Yeah.
Feet away.
Has anyone ever taken a line drive right back at them?
We have taken many.
Okay.
And
it's not
me personally being a pitcher my whole life, it's a painful thing to go through.
Well,
but
it's called softball, but it's not that
it
soft.
It is not soft at all.
Rockets off the bat.
No, it is not.
So,
I mean, we cry, we laugh.
I would cry.
It hurts,
I get hit with that.
But we have some really tough girls, and probably my toughest pitcher on the mound would be Taylor Piggott. She has taken line drive after line drive, and a lot of times she never cries, which is amazing to me, because it hurts.
I don't know. I'm playing this over in my mind. We talked about lacrosse last time. I don't know probably which would hurt more. Maybe I'm focusing too much on this, but a lacrosse ball from one of their wickets or a line drive softball?
You know, that's actually a really good question.
That's a good coach's challenge for some night.
That might be. Yeah. We might have to find someone to take that.
They always volunteer me for this stuff, so I don't know. Maybe we should just stop talking about this
right now. Somebody's going to get hurt.
Probably. No, I'm sure there's a lot of gasps when a line drive comes.
Oh, yes. We actually had a pitcher a couple years ago that I believe in practice took one off the head.
Ooh.
Luckily, I make all of my pitchers wear face masks now, so it caught the face mask.
I'd say that's
probably
a scary
one. That was a scary one.
Who works for the pitchers on techniques?
Me. That's why we've kind of this year broken practice up a little bit, and our pitchers and catchers come at 2:45, and then everybody else comes at 3:15, so that we get
you've got
all
instructional
that time. I've got until 2:45 to 3:30 with my pitchers while everybody else is warming up at 3:15.
Gotcha. That makes total sense.
And we do JV and varsity together every day, so I get all of them.
And now it sounds like we have some talent on this team that, you know, your father said the same thing. They're going to be playing after West Brunswick.
Oh, yeah. We do. We've got a couple of our seniors that have already signed. I think all three of our juniors two, if not three, of our juniors have already signed. I know one's going to Pfeiffer, and I cannot think of the other names, but we have got a lot of them that are going on to school. We've got others that will be signing. I know they will be.
Well, you might be their greatest asset when you start to talk to them about playing in college, because, I mean, you've done it.
Well, and that's why we try to run our practices like we do, because if we're light on them, they're not going to be ready. So we go as hard as we can, as long as we can. And
you're probably a lot nicer than most college coaches there, right?
That's kind of, I don't know.
Debatable.
You'd have to ask the girls that one.
I gotcha. Well, they don't know that yet.
They don't always think I'm nice.
Now, between you and your dad, who's the softie?
Honestly, I think we have a good balance of who goes off on him at what time.
So you play good cop, bad cop,
we
and trade
do.
Roles. Okay, that's effective.
Just the other day, I kind of went off on him a little bit and threw a fit and made him run.
He had to reel you back in just a little bit.
And he kind of sat back and just let me go. And but then today he went.
Did you have to tell him go cool off, eat an ice cream?
No, he actually had to tell me that the other day.
Sounds like you got some good give and take there.
Yeah, I'd say we do. I guess that's the benefit of working with Daddy.
Yeah, as long as you know who's supposed to be the good cop and who's supposed to be the bad cop at any given time, you should be good.
Yeah. So that tends to be how it goes.
Good motivational technique.
Oh, yeah.
Now we have an award that we give out every month, which is our West Brunswick Trojans Player of the Month Award from Wing and Fish Company. Who it is. We haven't announced it yet, but we're going to announce it on the show.
Okay.
Who's our Player of the Month?
This month we are going to go with Kenzie Benton.
Outstanding.
She's our senior shortstop, and she has consistently been hitting in the high 500s. I think the last time I looked, she was at 583. So she has, for the first year, I think only hit one home run, but she has been killing the ball.
Well, average says that's Player of the Month material right there.
Oh, yeah.
And there will be one in April, too.
There will be one, and I think we already have a couple in mind. We'll be looking at that.
Got to perform.
That's right.
They get some wings. It's a wonderful thing.
Yeah. They always love that. The girls love food.
Well, we like feeding them.
It's the key to their hearts, I'll tell you that.
It's a perfect match.
It is.
West Brunswick softball, or all West Brunswick sports, and Wing and Fish Company.
Yep, we love it.
Coach Nobles, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Good luck the rest of the way,
folks.
Thank you. If you haven't been out and support our softball team yet, it's high time. The weather is perfect, finally. I think it's 73 degrees out there. Go watch some softball. Stay tuned, because coming up next, we have a new addition to the Trojan family, and we're going to be talking to Coach Spivey about the baseball team. Go Trojans. Welcome back, Trojan fans. Folks, the Trojan family got a little bit bigger just a few days ago. Coach TJ Spivey is going to tell us all about it. Coach Spivey,
how you doing?
Welcome back.
Thanks for having me.
I understand you brought a new one into the world.
Yep, it's been a long week, but March 22nd at 10:57 a.m., me and my wife's life changed a lot.
But your family got 50%
bigger. 50%
bigger,
but you know, you always hear it's the happiest day of your life, and it was that and some. Yeah.
It was a pretty long day too, right?
Very, very. We actually went to the hospital Monday night, and she was in labor for 40 hours. So,
wow.
Having to be nice for a long time.
All you women out there, we respect you.
You're right. She is definitely the toughest person I know officially.
Wow. Tell us about your child.
She is a beautiful little girl named Ansley Grace. She was 8 pounds and 20 and a half inches. And, you know, we talk about it all the time. All we wanted from day one was a healthy little girl, and that's what we got.
That's what you got. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Do we have any Trojan onesies yet?
Oh, yeah, and we joked about this. You know you bleed Trojan green when you look in the hospital, and all our gifts were West Brunswick balloons, West Brunswick onesies. She's got more West Brunswick stuff now. We just got the new logo, and she's already got a onesie with the new logo on it. So that was pretty cool to see. Just a shout-out to Novant. They really treated us like family. It couldn't have been a better experience.
Outstanding.
We really fortunate to live in this community, because we got to see how much people in this community really do care about each other.
Well, we're fortunate to have you, Coach.
Because
not only do we are you making new Trojans, but you're winning baseball games too.
Yeah, and trying to do all of it at the same time.
That's a tough sprint right there. You couldn't have planned this for like basketball season?
No, this was I guess it was my fault. But
the world doesn't work that way. And folks, I was presented with a nice gift tonight. I now have my West Brunswick baseball
hat. You're official.
I am official now. Thank you, West. I feel like I'm somebody now.
That's right.
May not be completely accurate. We're just going to use a display for right now, but at least I feel good. Well, give us a rundown.
We are we're 7-3 right now, which the last time we talked, if you had told me we're going to be 7-3, I'd be really happy. And we could probably easily be 9-1. Two of the games we've lost were in extra innings. Mm. And we had both of them won and made a couple mistakes to hurt ourselves. We lost to one team that's just a little bit better than we were. And then we had two slip-ups. We were 7-2 going into a big game Friday night with Topsail. And, you know, after the game, we lose 5-4 in 9 innings. And I told the kids I could not be more proud of them. It's been a rough week for them, for me. You know, I had to miss a couple days.
I hope you missed a few days.
Yeah, half our team is battling the flu.
Ugh.
And, you know, win, lose, or draw, I was proud of our kids because a lot of them had really had to push through just to show up to school so they could play in that game. And for us to be competitive against a top five team in the state just says a lot about our leadership and says a lot about our character. So, you know, we never want to lose. But I think us battling like we did Friday night with literally half our team with the flu just shows how far this team can go.
I saw some long faces on Friday, but, you know, to lose a game like that, that's going to happen in the course of a baseball season. The regular season, you can't be perfect in baseball.
No.
There's too many games.
And one thing we talked about today, this is my third year here. Going back 2 years, we've been in a lot of one-run games, and we almost win every one of them. And this year we've lost 2 one-run games in extra innings, which hopefully tells me that the baseball guys are going to look after us later
than they
are early.
That's right.
So, you know, we're right where we need to be. So it's no reason to panic.
We got time to right whatever it is and sail the ship
Bunch of young. We have some really older guys that are pitching, but we have a lot of young guys that we're counting on, and they're just going to keep getting better and better. And I really like the chances of this team finishing stronger than we start, which is what it's all about.
Now, one of your JV players I saw the other day, and I know he's not up with the varsity yet, but he might be close. Of course, that's your decision. But he took himself out of the lineup because he punched a base.
Yeah, that was not very smart.
Yep.
And he learned from that. We talked about that.
I should say he did.
He's a really great kid, and he's worked way too hard to let his emotions ruin all that hard work. So
what's your take on base punching?
Yeah, we're not about that. We don't punch bases, and we don't throw helmets, and we don't disrespect the game.
I laugh because I know he's okay, and he's already
come
back.
Yeah, he's playing right now.
Yeah. And that shows me that's a tough kid, and there's a lot of tough players in that lineup for you.
Well, he's worked his butt off in the weight room. He was that close to ruining his season because of bad judgment. But, you know, I also want to give a shout-out to my JV team. They are 10-0. Probably about to be 11-0. They're playing right now. So, you know, those kids love baseball, and they work really hard.
Let me stop you for a second. Between the two teams, we're a combined 17-3.
Hopefully 18-3 in the next hour.
And you can't count chickens before they hatch, but I feel you. And we have a new Trojan.
That's right.
That has all the gear already. How long until she can start carrying bats around? I don't have a lot of experience with newborns.
Hopefully about 18 months. No,
okay. We might have to ask your wife if that's okay.
I'm really proud of those guys, and I'm really proud of Coach Cruz and Coach Rozier. They've done a great job with our young guys, and I feel like we do a really good job of, our JVs practice with us every day, and they're our future. If you want to be successful forever, you got to really focus on those young guys.
That's the future of the program. And you're fairly young at the varsity level this year too, correct?
Like I said, we lose a good senior class, but we have no juniors. We're seniors and then as sophomores and freshmen. So one good thing about this area, We have really good kids that work hard, and we just kind of keep it going every year.
So I'm going to hold you to this now. If we, you know, and I expect we'll win a state title this year, but if we don't win it this year, I definitely expect to win one next year.
That's always our goal. When that stops being our goal, we're going to have to find someone else.
We got a problem.
That's right. So,
Coach, I can see your head swelling just a little bit because we've been dumping these accolades on you tonight. But I understand that the West Brunswick baseball program's won another honor that has a lot to do maybe with your success out there.
Well, it has a lot to do with a lot of people. Long before I got here and years and years of doing it right. But last year we won 2016 Region 2 Field of the Year, which is voted on by all baseball coaches in the state.
It's beautiful out there. This is what you'd see, I feel like, at maybe like a double-A stadium sometimes. I played on some crummy fields growing up. This ain't one of them.
You know, like I said, a lot of people had to do with this. You know, our parks and rec help us out a lot. Coach A been out there 26 years, and we have a field maintenance class that does a lot. Our kids take pride in our field, and our parents and booster club help us raise the money. And the reason why it's Field of the Year is because every year we do something to make it a little bit nicer. We never get complacent. Just like last year we won Field of the Year, and since winning Field of the Year, we've installed a new halo behind home plate. If you don't know what that is, it's just a piece of turf that makes it look really nice, and you're talking about a $15,000 project.
Grass ain't cheap.
No, especially when you start putting logos on it.
That's right, and it gets more traffic than just you.
Oh,
there's adult leagues that play on there. That a lot goes into making sure that it can take that kind of abuse and still look as beautiful as it does.
We get phone calls and emails every summer, all these travel tournaments they want to play on our field. So a travel tournament will play at UNCW, Coastal Carolina, and West Brunswick.
There you go. You know, two colleges and a high school.
You can't beat that. Nah. So.
And it's not like we're talking plastic turf either. This is the real deal.
This is the real deal, or at least they charge the real deal.
No turf burns,
No.
You might get some grass stains. That's all right.
Yeah, we clean them off.
That's what makes baseball great.
But, it's something that we're really proud of. You know, we can't always control the talent we have, but we can control what our field looks like. And, you know, like I said, just a lot of people have taken pride in that facility, and I'm proud just to be a small part of it.
Look, basketball's got a new court to play on. Baseball's got Field of the Year.
That's right.
So when you come out and support the Trojans, you're going to be at the prettiest high school facility really you could reasonably be at.
Check out that. We got a nice new sign out there in the left field just to remind people.
We need to let everybody know what we've accomplished here.
That's right.
Let's talk about some of your assistant coaches. How did they handle that with your absence?
Really good. I mean, it also helps when you have a guy that did it 26 years before you. And then I got another guy that, you know, is much older and been doing it a long time as well. And I have first time in my career, I got four really good assistant coaches, and they never skipped a beat. And, you know, I couldn't appreciate that more.
I got a feeling Coach A was pretty proactive when you had to visit the hospital.
Very. And I think matter of fact, a funny story about Coach A,
we're all ears.
We're in labor for a couple of days. And finally, when it's time to go, I hear Coach A's voice coming down the hallway. And he got to the door. And it just so that's the exact moment that it was time to start pushing. And they had to stop him at the door. I said, look, all we needed was Coach A to come up and back, clean up, and get this thing started.
Positive encouragement right
there. So that was good. Coach A's been really good to me, and I appreciate everything he's done for me.
That's props to Coach A. If you can't count on him,
that's right.
You don't have much.
That's right.
So. Well, you know, we've got a long season to go. Are you going to have the energy to finish this?
Yes. It gets a little bit better every day. Friday night was tough. We didn't get out of the hospital until 1 o'clock, and I'm coaching a game at 6 o'clock. Mm. And my energy level was not very high. But our kids, our seniors, pulled us through it. But I'm good to go now. I got my 2 hours of sleep last night. What else do you need?
That's right. Well, we've got – who's our next game here?
We play – we got a long week. We play Ashley tomorrow at Ashley. And any road game in our conference is tough. It doesn't matter who you're playing. So we got to really go over there and mentally grind one out and find a way to steal a win. And then we're back home Wednesday against Harrell's Academy. And then back home Friday against the number two 4A team in the state, New Hanover. So it's a big week.
hey, but the bar is high.
That's right.
Yeah. You got an extra cheerleader at home, so I got full faith that you're going to make the most of these opportunities.
She'll be out there soon, hopefully by the Easter tournament.
Well, that's our goal. We just had Coach Nobles up here. She said that softball throwing is a natural motion. So I don't know when they start at fast pitch, but it can't be more than 2 or 3 years.
That's right. So, we're going to start with reading books first and go from there.
There you go. Got to study first.
That's right. So,
other big happenings in the sports world, I got to bring it up. The Final Four is this weekend. Tell us your thoughts. I know you're biased, but tell us your thoughts on this Final Four.
I'm just happy to see two Carolina teams in the Final Four. I'm not a South Carolina fan at all, probably one of my least favorite teams. But I do think it would be fun to see Carolina versus the real Carolina.
I got a feeling the way the Gamecocks play defense, we might well see that final.
You know, obviously grew up a Carolina Tar Heel fan my whole life, so that was fun to watch.
And they're the favorite, let's be honest. They're
absolutely
the
favorite. The way they run the floor and get after it. And, you know, Coach Williams, I saw a tweet today. He's definitely got more games in the Final Four than all the other three.
Oh, yeah. I'm just kind of concerned, though. You know, we live in the Carolinas. Obviously, those two teams are going to get the most coverage around here. Oregon destroyed Kansas.
Yeah.
And I didn't see that coming at all. By the time South Carolina made it to the eight, I said, you know, they're good. Oregon, that to me came completely out of left field. Are we going to overlook the Ducks maybe?
Well, I think it's you can until the Final Four. I think when you get to the Final Four, you're not going to overlook anybody. And kind of like you said about South Carolina, that hurts them a little bit. No one's going to overlook you in the Final Four. However, if you play defense, you can win at any sport.
That's right.
So they got a chance because they're just going to play so hard. But, you know, it's Final Four is like any sport, like baseball, football. You better be healthy, you better be lucky, and you better be good.
Yeah. At this point, all those teams potentially can be that. There's a Final Four connection, too, with West Brunswick.
Yeah, our assistant basketball coach last year, Coach Batts, who left to go be a head coach, he was Luke May's head coach at Huff High School in Charlotte.
If you don't know, folks, Luke May hit the shot. This might go down as one of the most famous shots of all time in Carolina basketball history.
It was a big one.
Shot that beat Kentucky. You know, everybody knows I'm a solid orange guy, but I think I jumped off the couch about 4 feet when that went down. And his father actually played and was a high school All-American at my high school in Charlotte, Independence. So we got all kinds of connections.
Another little story about him I saw tweet this morning. He hits that big shot last night and shows up to his 8 a.m. class.
They were impressive. In Memphis yesterday. That's what it's all about, student athletes.
True student athlete there. I had to tip my cap because I can't say I would have been at 9 o'clock, maybe 8 o'clock, no chance.
He probably didn't sleep much last night, you know. Well, Coach, I won't keep you anymore. I bet you have to stop by a JV game, probably pick up something at the store.
Change some diapers.
Get home, change some diapers, and let your wife get some rest.
That's right, and get them 2 hours of sleep tonight.
But congratulations. Yeah, I mean, you might get 2.5 hours if you're lucky.
Doubtful.
Congratulations on your new addition to the family, and congratulations on a great start to the season, both JV and varsity.
We appreciate it. Come out and support our kids. We got great kids, and they work hard, and they deserve it.
We got home games this week, and the weather's perfect, so no excuse.
Best hot dogs in Brunswick County at our concession stand.
You get a hot dog, a Pepsi, a Life Water, and enjoy the afternoon.
That's right.
Go Trojans.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.